Everyone, this is Jaka, your host for today's episode. The martial art that we are featuring today is originated in Thailand. And in fact, it is a nationwide game of Thailand and a historical one. It is also fast growing in Asia and in the Philippines. Muay Thai. It is still a non-Olympic sport. Muay Thai is known as the science of eight limbs because of the full use of the hands, shins, elbows, and knees in fighting. But how did the sport come to being? Are you interested to know the answer? Pakinggan natin ang isa namang kwento ni Commissioner Celia Kiram.
Ang aking ibabahaging kwento sa inyo ngayon ay tungkol sa nakakawiling kaalaman sa kasaysayan ng Muay Thai. Ang Muay Thai, na kilala rin Thai boxing sa Ingles, ay isang pambansang sport at kulturang martial art ng Thailand. Ito ay may mga pinagmulan sa sinaunang mga taktika sa battlefield ng hukbong Siamese o Thai. Kilala rin ito bilang isang close combat na gamit ang buong katawan bilang sandata. Alam niyo ba na ang Muay Thai ay tinukoy bilang the art of eight limbs o ang paggamit ng walong puntos ng pakikipag-ugnay sa katawan upang gayahin ang mga sandata ng digmaan. Tulad ng paggamit ng mga kamay na gumagaya sa isang tabak o punyal. Ang mga shins at braso ay pinatitigas sa pagsasanay upang magamit laban sa mga suntok. Ang siko ay gamit tulad ng isang mabigat na martilyo. Ang mga binti at tuhod naman ay nagiging palakol at gamit sa pagtumba ng kalaban. Alam niyo rin ba na si Nai Kanong Tong ang tinaguriang ama ng Muay Thai sa Thailand? Siya rin ay labis na ginagalang bilang bayani ng Muay Thai. Ipinagdiriwang ng buong bansa ang March 17 taong-taon bilang Nai Kanong Tom Day o National Muay Thai Day. Ngunit sino nga ba si Nai Kanong Tom? Ayon sa kwento taong 1774, siya ay naging isa sa mga libo-libong Siamese prisoners noong panahong sinalakay ni Burmese King Mangra ang Ayutthaya Kingdom o City of Ayutthaya. Napili si Nai Kanong Tom ng hari upang kalabanin ang isang Burmese boxing champion at na-knockout niya ito. Hindi na kontento ang hari, nagpadala uli siya ng siyam na fighters na isa-isa at sunod-sunod na lumaban kay Nai Kanong Tong na walang pahinga. At lahat ay tinumba ni Nai Kanong Tong. Napahanga niya ang hari at yan ang nagudyok sa kanyang upang bigyan ng kalayaan ang City of Ayutthaya kasama si Nai Kanong Tong at mga Siamese Thais. Alam niyo rin ba na ang Muay Thai ay nagkaroon ng maraming mga mukha at itinatag sa buong mundo bilang isang tanyag na ring sport? Ito ay kilala bilang isang fitness form na kilala rin bilang Muay Aerobic. Tanyag din ito bilang isang form ng self-defense na tinatawag na Muay Boran. At dyan nagwawakas ang kwento tungkol sa sport na Muay Thai. Muli, ito ang inyong Commissioner Kiram na walang sawang maghahatid ng kwentong kababaihan, kwento para sa mga kaalaman at karunungan sa sport.
Thank you, Commissioner Celia Kirang, for that interesting history of Muay Thai. The Muay Thai Association of the Philippines and its current leadership have been instituting programs and reforms to develop women Muay Thai in this country. Let us listen to the Association Secretary General, Pearl Managilod, as she speaks her mind on its efforts on the development of women Muay Thai.
When I was asked to step in as Secretary General in 2016, it was I had a lot of struggles and challenges because, like what you said, it's a male-dominated sport. So when I became SecGen, there was no other female in the management position except for one other board member. We didn't have any female coaches. We had one female athlete. So I felt so alone. And then it was all the other chapter members were all male. So they were just looking at me like, do you even know what you're doing? And I think it just became my default that every time we plan something, women have to be involved. It's always like, where are the women? Where are the women? It's not enough women, you know? So I think they started to pick up on that. So everybody now within the organization has that mentality now. Okay, where are the women? So every time there's something going on, a project, a commission, it's always like, oh, nasaan yung mga babae? So, you know, we really see a lot of women now in Muay Thai. We're very excited. One of our athletes now, she just won ONE FC, the championship last Friday. We have more women athletes. We have our female coach. We have more technical officials that are women. So yeah, we're very happy with the way things are going for Muay Thai.
Wow, we are so glad to hear that. So what used to be male-dominated sport, Muay Thai is now unfolding to becoming a sport where our Filipino women and girls can play with much gusto and, yes, can also excel in international competitions. Take a look at this. Women's silver medalist Islay Erika Bomawau and Jenalyn Olsim are idols to look up to by our young and promising women and girls who are into Muay Thai. In the recent virtual edition of the 7th Martial Arts Festival in Muay Thai, we have seen women and girls showcasing their best forms. And today, we shall be presenting to you the gold medalist, as we are also very excited to listen to them as they share their dreams as an athlete. Here are the gold medalists in the virtual edition of the 7th Martial Arts Festival in Muay Thai, the country's rising stars in this sport. Atasha Althea Amugis of General Santos City, match fit youth 10-year-old category. Keith Margaret Palinas of General Santos City earned gold in Max Fit Youth 11-year-old category, YCRIU Youth 12-year-old category, Shadowbox Youth 11-year-old category, and in AeroFit Below 15 category.
Bout finished. Great job.
Pandemic situation never hindered me to stop working out, in which I got my 4 gold medals in the recent Women's Martial Arts Festival 2021 competition. Through this, I dream bigger that somehow I can help my family financially and finish my studies to be a successful doctor, and who knows, get a chance to be one of the participants in the Olympics someday. Yes! Someday in God's will. As I always said to myself, don't quit. Suffer now and live the rest of your life as a champion. Jasmine Degame of Taytay Rizal, Max Fit Youth, 12-year-old category, Shadowbox Youth, 12-year-old category.
Hi, my name is Jasmine Degame, and as an athlete, I've been dreaming to compete around the world and win as a champion, so I can have a chance to be in the national team of Muay Thai and be a coach. Well, every day, because of my coach, I've been inspired the way she teaches every athlete, and I really want to share this knowledge and skills in the sport Muay Thai and make a small change in this world.
Nivi Jolie Cañete, General Santos City, Max Fit Youth, 13 years old category. Rizal Chen said, Rizal Chen Sevilliano of General Santos City, Max Fit Youth, 14-year-old category, Shadowbox Youth, 14-year-old category, Aerofit Belil, 15-year-old category.
Round two.
My goal bilang isang Muay Thai athlete is to become Philippine team in Muay Thai and to give pride in our nation and give inspiration to other youth. And also finish my study through scholarship of Muay Thai sports for my future and help my family and others and God bless everyone.
Chelsea Eleuterio Bulfa of General Santos City, Max Fit Youth, 15-year-old category. Thank you. Haziel Barbero of Davao City, MaxFit Youth 16-year-old category. Richie Nusores from General Santos City, MaxFit Youth, 17-year-old category, YKBU Youth, 18-year-old category. Jamila Alawi of Davao City, MaxFit Youth, 18-year-old category.
Pangarap ko po bilang atleta ay makakapagtapos ng pag-aaral at makakapaglaro sa ibang bansa, tulad ng SEA Games, Olympic at marami pang iba. Alam kong imposible na mangyari yon dahil sa mahina ako at pinangako sa sarili ko na balang araw magiging malakas ako at mangyayari yon. Kahit hindi man sumusuporta dito yung mga magulang ko at saka relatives ko, kahit ako lang sumusuporta sa sarili ko dahil sa mababa yung paningin nila sa akin dahil sa wala daw akong mararating dito, pero go nang go pa rin ako. At saka gusto ko din maging black belt para balang araw may papamana ko yun sa mga anak ko. At balang araw matatawag din ako ng papa ko na anak ko yan at proud na proud ako sa iyo. At bilang atleta, yun lang po yung gusto kong mangyari sa buhay ko. Salamat po.
Colleen Veron of Antipolo City, Maxfit Youth, 18 to 40 years old, 60 kilograms category.
Isang atleta ay maging isa sa atletang Philippine team at mairepresenta ang ating bansa sa bawat laban. Sa mga kababaihan po na gustong subukan ang sports na ito, huwag po kayong matakot, kundi ay ito rin ay gawin yung pampalakas ng katawan, self-defense at kahiligan. Maraming salamat po.
Genlex Pior of Davao City, Maxfit Youth, 18 to 40 years old, 60 kilograms category.
Hi, I'm Jen, and my dream as an athlete is to continue my training while pursuing my goals to be an architect and an artist. And I also want to be an inspiration to young children, especially young girls. I want them to know that they can be anyone who they want to be, and they can achieve anything as long as they put their mind and heart into it. Nothing is impossible, and never, ever give up.
Maraluz Dagame from Taytay Rizal, YKRIU Youth, 10-year-old category, Shadowbox Youth, 10-year-old category. Thank you.
I'm 10 years old from Taytay, Rizal. My ambition as an athlete is to have gold medals and to become a future champion to represent the Philippines in Muay Thai all over the world.
Janelle Grace Tagame of Taytay, Rizal, YPU Youth 14-year-old category.
Hi, I'm Janelle Grace Didagame. As an athlete, I want to train harder and harder every day to become stronger and be a Muay Thai champion just like my coach is. And I want to learn Muay Thai to use it as a self-defense and to be physically fit. I also want to experience competing with other countries and raise our flag. And I'm also inspired to Heidelin Diaz because she helped her family choose sports and my family was always with me, so I want to help them too.
Eileen Alumno, Baguio City, YPU Youth 18 to 40 years old category.
Bilang atleta, pangarap ko pong manalo or maging champion po sa lahat ng kompetisyon na aking sasalihan sapagkat yun po yung paraan ko para makapagpasalamat sa tao, sa lahat ng taong sumuporta, naniwala at tumulong sa akin gaya na lamang po ng aking mga pamilya, mga kaibigan at mga kakilala. Liban sa pagiging champion, bilang isang atleta, pangarap ko rin pong magsilbing inspirasyon sa kabataan na paghusayan pa at maging determinado sa pag-abot ng kanya-kanyang pangarap. Katulad na lamang po ni Miss Heidelin Diaz at iba pa pong atleta na nag-uwi ng mga medalya sa ating bansa. Bilang isang atleta, goal ko rin po na mag-uwi ng karangalan sa ating bansa.
Princess Reyes Ilocosur, Shadowbox Youth, 13-year-old category.
Thank you. sports, I can empower women. We live in a world where men often think that they can outsmart us through brutal force merely because they believe that they are better based on the fact that they are men. As a matter of fact, sports isn't just all about fitness. By doing sports, women gain freedom, power, strength, dignity, and respect. I also desire to represent my province, Ilocosur, at every competition.
Betty Mature Ping, Baguio City, Shadow Box Youth, 17-year-old category.
Fighter. Gusto ko pong maging champion in the future po. And I gusto ko rin pong maging national athlete para ma-represent ang ating bansa. Hindi po madali ang sport na to. Kailangan po ng disiplina, determination, at pagmamahal sa ginagawa. And especially po, kailangan po ng pananalig sa Diyos at dapat pasalamatan yung mga taong tumutulong at sumusuporta sa'yo, especially yung family and yung mga coaches mo.
Venus Binwihan of Baguio City, Shadow Box Youth, 18-year-old category.
And bilang isang atleta, isa po sa pinakapangarap ko ay maging isang national athlete, kung papala rin po. Isa po kasi ito sa pangarap ng tatay ko para sa akin. Kahit na nakaigad na siya, I still wanna make his proud. Gusto kong ituloy kung ano man po yung nasimulan niya sa sports na ito. And wish ko po someday, in the future maybe, gusto ko pong i-represent po ang ating bansa, ang bansang Pilipinas. Gusto ko din pong maranasan yung maraming nagsusuporta sa'yo, yung kapwa mong Pinoy na nagsusuporta sa'yo sa mga laban mo. Kaya yun, I still keep on praying na Lord, sana in the future, isa din ako sa mga atletang nagre-represent ang bansa. If God's will, I will do my best. all my best. That's all and thank you.
Ralph Chin Yusores of General Santos City, Shadowbox Youth 18 to 40-year-old category. Juna Micah Clarito and Charlene Bruce from General Santos City, Aerofit below 18 to 40 years old category.
Baby, can't you see? I'm calling. Got you. Should have warned.
Myself becoming an athlete because all my life I dedicate myself into arts. But then I found myself competing in a ring one day. Becoming an athlete helps me to develop my good character. It's not just helps me to become strong physically, but also teaches me to be strong in our daily lives. Whatever problems we may encounter, that will help me to grow as a person. I want to be someone that can be a role model to others, not just to my fellow athletes, but also to the people surrounding me. I may not be the strongest nor skillful athlete, but I have the dedication to be a better athlete day by day. I am not who I am today without the support of my coaches, our parents, and especially to our Almighty God. This is all thanks to them.
That was a great show. We cannot afford to end the show without giving you a sample of a mom who have built a very promising athlete. We have invited a special mom of a 4-time gold medalist, the most demedaled in the virtual edition of this year's 7th Martial Arts Festival. The doting and loving mom of Keith Magareth Balinas,
Mommy Marizel Balinas of General Santos City.
Ano niyo kinalak ni Ogilobo si Keith? Anong klaseng bata si Keith?
Keith Margaret and her brother are raised to be responsible children. As a parents, we always tell Keith that in order to survive, never forsake her studies and be an academically excellent to have a good life in the future, and at the same time, the importance of self-defense that she can use it wherever she goes. We teach her to be a God-fearing kid, always give thanks to the Lord, and respect her elders and siblings. As a kid, Kit is an obedient daughter to us and to her coaches. A shy type of girl, but it never hindered her to be a competitive one, not only in her academic endeavor, but also in other contests she joined, like Muay Thai competition. Every time she aims something, she worked harder to get the first place. And if sometimes she failed to make it, like any other kids, she cried, and our hearts as a parents cried too with her, but we always told her to never give up.
Paano napahilig si Kate sa sport ng Muay Thai? Ilang taon siya nung nagsimula siyang maglaro?
At the age of 3, Kate showed interest in martial arts. She witnessed her brother practicing Muay Thai in one of the old martial arts school in General Santos City. Every time she watched action movies like Karate Kid or any martial arts movies, she then stood up and did the kicks, punch, or ginagaya niya kung anong ginagawa sa movie. Since then, she always told us that she wanted to enroll. And so, early this year, she attended a Muay Thai session together with her older brother and cousins. At first, it is only her curiosity to join the training. But after a week, when her trainer, Master Raul Sibiliano of Muma Muay Warriors of General Santos City, introduced the beauty of the sports and taught her well, which makes her in love the sports.
Anong klase mami ko kayo kay Kate? Paano ko siya sinusuportahan sa kanyang hilig sa sport ng Muay Thai?
As her mom, I am her personal assistant, manager, a tutor teacher in studies, or even as a feeling coach during her competition. As long as she says, I want to continue, I will support her dream sports all the way. In all her local and national competitions, even we are financially constrained, especially this pandemic, to support her training expenses, we just tell her to just focus on your competition. I will do everything as I can in order she will achieve her goals in life. In all her trainings, either early morning or late night schedule, hatid sundo ko siya. Win or lose, I am there for her.
Paano niya nababalanse ang kanyang pag-aaral at paglalaro o training sa kanyang iSports?
Every day, she allocated time to study her lessons, finish all her school assignments, and do other academic tasks, and then training. She see to it that either her school or her sports will not be sacrificed. We always reminding her if she cannot balance her academic and sports, then she must choose what to prioritize. But with her perseverance, dedication, and self-discipline, she make it both. Actually, I humbly say, she is rank 1 in her grade level since grade 1 to grade 5 at Notre Dame of the Dangas University, Ibed Lagao, General Santos City.
Napakasarap pakinggan ng isang mommy na napaka-supportive sa isang anak na atleta tulad ni Keith. Maraming salamat po. the Muay Thai Association of the Philippines has prepared a very inspiring and moving video for all of us, entitled Pagbangon. Let's watch this. To rise up and continue to live our lives to the fullest. Kailangan natin bumangon. Ang esport ay isang pamamaraan upang bumangon at ma-empower natin ang ating mga sarili at buhay. Thank you very much to all our guests. Once again, congratulations to our gold, silver, and bronze medalists. Thank you also to all athletes, coaches, and technical officials who all have made this virtual competition successful. To our tournament director, Mr. Edil Mina, and to all those involved in organizing this year's virtual competition, congratulations. Thank you to our partner, the Muay Thai Association of the Philippines, and its president, General Lucas Monagilod. Time is up. Thank you for watching Rise Up, Shape Up, a public service show brought to you by the Philippine Sports Commission, Women in Sports. Please don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, Rise Up, Shape Up. Have a marvelous day, everyone. Rise.